In this video, I'm going to show you how to navigate through the new PI Coresight 2014 homepage and how you can now view PI ProcessBook displays in your browser. First, to navigate to the PI Coresight homepage, if you're unfamiliar with the URL you need to use, you can check that. If you are on the PI Coresight machine looking in IIS Manager, you can see here I have Coresight selected, and I'll use the Browse option over here on the right. This opens up the browser to the URL, and if I want to access the PI Coresight homepage remotely, I'll just need to replace localhost with cnm-coresight, which is my PI Coresight machine name. So I've done that right here. If you've used PI Coresight before, looking at this new homepage, you can see that it has a different look to it. This new homepage was built on HTML5 and therefore is now accessible from any device that has a modern web browser. And the mobile site and the PI ProcessBook viewer were also built on HTML5. As we look at all the displays here, some of these displays you can see are PI ProcessBook displays, and others are the more traditional PI Coresight displays. Perhaps one of the most exciting new features of PI Coresight is the ability to import displays created in PI ProcessBook and to see them in your browser. Let's take a look at New Green Distilling, one of these PI ProcessBook displays. So I'm here, I'm viewing it in my browser, and I have the option to look at different time ranges at the bottom, or to scroll back in time and look at how my process has changed. These PI ProcessBook displays have to be saved to a central share, and then they can be viewed like we're doing right now. Let me navigate back to the home page using the PI Coresight button here. And let's take a look at the folders that have the PI ProcessBook files. The folder structure is provided down here. Right now, you can see that there are two different shared folders that are being monitored by the PI Coresight server. I can look at which displays are from which folder, and you'll notice that the subfolder structure is even preserved, so I can do further organization there. How does PI Coresight decide which folders to monitor? That's something that's set up in the PI Coresight Administration page. I'll just navigate there by adding an admin to the end of the URL. And we're going to look at Import Folder Management. Under Locations, you can see the ProcessBook folders that have been set up. And the friendly name is what's being actually displayed for that particular folder in PI Coresight. You'll notice that while one of these folders is on the PI Coresight machine as well, you can have remote folders that are shared too. Let me show you how, once we add a ProcessBook display to that shared folder, that it can be picked up and viewed in PI Coresight. So I have this Element Relative ProcessBook display file here, and I'm going to save it to the shared folder. So I have that saved, and we can see that it's in the shared folder right here. It's called ERD Turbine Wind Conditions. I'm going to go back to the PI Coresight homepage, all displays, and then I'm going to see if PI Coresight picks up that PI ProcessBook file. Looks like it hasn't picked it up yet based on the number of displays I have, so let me give it a minute and then I'll refresh and make sure it got picked up. Okay, it's been a minute, so I'm going to go ahead and hit refresh. Great. My latest display has shown up and I can see it right down here, and I'm actually going to navigate straight to it. Here's the Element Relative display that we just added. And I want to show you how you can still look at different elements, since right now it's only showing the data that's specific to this particular asset. In order to do that, I'm going to need to slightly modify the URL. I'm going to add this to the end. There's the question mark, current element equals. And the rest of it is just navigating to that element through my AF hierarchy. This is the name of my AF server. Then I have my AF database, the parent element, and then the different elements that my element relative display is based off of. Right now you can see that I'm looking at the fifth turbine. Let's take a look at the eighth one. Okay, let me jump back to the home page. Talk a little bit about how we can organize displays. You can see right now there's 23 displays, and even with 23 displays, scrolling down to find the particular display that maybe I want to look at, and I look at very frequently, makes me wonder, is there a way that I can make this faster? One thing that I can do is I can use the star to add this display to my favorites. Right now we are looking at all displays, but let's jump to favorites. And these are all the displays that my specific user has essentially starred to add to favorites. I can also look at my displays and the recent displays. Some other things that can be helpful for quickly finding displays is I can use the search here to search by name. So that pulls up the display that we're looking at. You also notice there's this filter by labels. And right now, there's a particular label that has been assigned called renewable. And this is just a label that we're using to help keep track of all the displays that are related to the renewable energy assets. Now this one's wind turbine status, but now that I think about it, that element relative display that has the wind conditions should get this label too. So let's go ahead and add that to that display. In order to do that, we're going to edit the display settings and add that renewable label. I'll go ahead and save that. And then let me go ahead and switch to all displays. Now if I filter by the renewable label, I'll get both of them. Now these labels are useful if you're doing the filter by label. But even if I'm looking at displays that have labels, you'll notice that I have the option to look at related displays by just clicking on this too. And this gets me to that same spot that we were just at. So these are really great tools that I can use to help organize my displays. And if you think about it, these are not only my displays, but other people are also creating their displays as well that I can see. For instance, this display was created by myself, but this display was created by one of my colleagues. The reason why I can see this display is because they made this display public, which is noted by this symbol, versus private displays have this one. If I want to share a display that I've made with others, I can edit the display settings for the PI Coresight displays, and I can choose between private and public right here. I'm the display owner, but I could change the display ownership through this, and I can even delete the display, as you can see down here. Now the other option that we haven't covered yet is read-only. Let's talk about what read-only means in PI Coresight. Let me open a read-only display. And I can tell this is read-only based on this. Read-only doesn't mean that I can't do anything once I'm looking at this display. I can still delete the trend symbol, and if I want, maybe I want to focus on adding some new items from line one. I can still do all these things. What read-only means is if anybody else goes to this, or if I simply refresh, the display will return to its original format, just like we saw at the beginning. Now, if I want to modify a display or make my own display, since maybe I don't want to have this trend here, I can go ahead and create a new display using this button right here. If Silverlight is not installed on your machine when you're trying to access PI Coresight, you will not have this new display button. So make sure that Silverlight is installed. And the last thing that I want to leave you with is just a really quick look at what the mobile site looks like. Here we are looking at the site production overview. And if I want to check out the mobile site, I'll just need to append an M at the end of the URL. It looks different, but I can still do a search here at the bottom. And we're just looking at the site production overview, so let me see how it looks in the mobile site so I have a good idea of what to expect. So I can see that they show up basically as these items here. And let me also do a search for one of the PI ProcessBook displays that we looked at earlier. Great, I can look at the PI ProcessBook displays too from the mobile site. Hope you feel comfortable navigating through the new PI Coresight 2014 homepage now and are able to check out those PI ProcessBook displays on your own browser.